Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video I am going to discuss the selection of refrigerant and absorbent and the selection of the mixture of refrigerant and absorbent. So before I start, I want to say that if you find this video useful, please subscribe to the channel and like the video so that I can make more and more videos for you. The first thing is that what is the selection criteria of a refrigerant? So the first point is the boiling point. The boiling point of the refrigerant should be in the range of 2 degree to 10 degree Celsius at an operating condition of 40 degree Celsius. That means it should have a low boiling point. The second thing is that the critical temperature should be high. The third thing is that the latent heat of vaporization should be high for a refrigerant. And the specific heat should be low. And the stability in complete cycle should be there in a refrigerant. So it is very easy to remember, the refrigerant have a condition of latent heat of vaporization high, specific heat low, and high critical temperature and low boiling point. So now we will find what is the operating condition for an absorbent. The first thing is that it should remain liquid under the operating temperature, because an absorbent is always a liquid. The second thing is that it should have a greater affinity for refrigerant. So as it is an absorbent, it has to induct the refrigerant, so it should have the affinity for the refrigerant. The heat liberated when the refrigerant is absorbed should be much low. In order to have a good absorbent, the heat should not be liberated much when it absorbs the refrigerant. The boiling point should be high, and just opposite to that of a refrigerant. The specific heat should be low, just like the refrigerant, and it should be a chemically stable. Now is the characteristics of the mixture of refrigerant and absorbent that should be possessed. The first thing is that it should have high solubility in absorber but low solubility in generator. The second thing is that the refrigerant should be more volatile than the absorbent. The third point is that both should be chemically stable, and both should not form any solid phase as it can cause blockage in the system. The fifth point is that the absorbent should have a strong affinity as discussed earlier. The sixth point is that both should not cause corrosion as it will affect the efficiency of the system. And the seventh and last point is that both should not be toxic and should not be inflammable. Hope you find this video useful. Please subscribe to the channel. And see all the videos related to mechanical engineering. Thank you.